Let's look at interval notation. Interval notation is a convenient notation for number line graphs instead of using inequality notation. You need to scan the number line from left to right since the number on the left is always smaller than the number on the right in interval notation. We're going to express the following inequality notations into interval notation, but I strongly suggest that you graph the inequality first and scan from left to right. So in this first problem, I have got x is greater than negative 5. Now if you remember when you graphed linear inequalities, we have to use an open circle when I have greater than or less than. And in number 2, if you'll notice, I have an or equal. And for me to distinguish between these two types of problems, an or equal will always have a closed or solid circle. So back to number 1. I'm going to make my number line, put an open circle on negative 5, and I'm going to graph or shade everything to the right. So let's see if I did that. Now in this, if you'll notice, there's my open circle I am shading. But now remember, I need a left and a right number or value. And since this number line goes all the way to positive infinity, that will be my right-hand value. So scanning from left to right, I run into the shading at negative 5. The shading goes to infinity. So in interval notation, I would have parentheses negative 5, comma infinity in parentheses. Now just like I have an open circle here and a solid circle here, I also have to have different symbols to indicate an open or a solid circle. So when I have an open, I always have parentheses. When I'm referring to infinity or negative infinity, I always use parentheses. So we'll see a different symbol used for the equal to's. So let's graph this one. Number line on 2, I'm going to have a solid circle and I'm going to shade to my left. If you'll notice, it's going to negative infinity. So as I scan, I run into negative infinity. I end the shading at 2. So I should have parentheses negative infinity, comma 2. And now on the 2, I indicate a solid or closed circle with a bracket. Now let's look at number 3. On my number line at negative 3, I'm going to have a closed circle. At 1, I'm going to have an open. If you'll notice, I want my x value, my x's to be between those two numbers, so that's where I shade. So that's what my graph looks like. Also notice my numbers on this particular number line are going by 2's. So as I do my scanning from the left, I see my shading starts at negative 3, including it goes to 1, and that's where it stops. So see if you see this. I'm going to have a bracket, negative 3, comma, 1, parentheses. And hopefully that's what I've got there. There it is. So here's your inequality notation. This is the graphical version, and these are called your interval notation. Very quick. Now in the following 3 problems, we're going to express using interval notation and inequality. So you need to pause me, and you go ahead and you do these particular problems and see if you end up with what I've got. In this one, if I do interval notation first, the shading starts at negative 1, it goes to infinity. I need parentheses around those two numbers because it's open and infinities always get parentheses. Now in the inequality notation, I would have x is greater than negative 1. So there's that one. In this one, sort of similar to number 3 earlier, in my interval notation, shading starts at 0, ends at 3, but to indicate the difference in the type of circles, I'm going to have a parentheses at the 0 and a bracket at the 3. In the inequality notation, x is in the middle, so I'm going to have 0 less than x less than or equal to 3. I've got one more. A little bit different. If you'll notice, I've got two different parts of the number line that's shaded, and I have to indicate both of those separately. The first one, in interval notation, I would go from negative infinity to negative 2, parentheses around both. Let me move this just a little bit. So there's the first part. Now, to indicate there is another section that's shaded, you use what's called a union, which means or. On this one, my shading on this part starts at 1, goes to infinity. I need a bracket, comma, infinity, parentheses. So there's my interval notation for the number line. Inequality, I would have x less than negative 2 or x greater than or equal to 1. Now, in the textbook, they'll ask for interval notation and or inequality notation, so you really need to be able to be proficient at both of those. Thank you.